So this is the study called SOLAR-1. It's a phase 3 study testing alpelisib in patients with hormone receptor positive, HER2 negative breast cancer. So what are we talking about? We are talking about patients with HR positive, HER2 negative metastatic breast cancer. And as you know, this patient have a median survival that is very short. It's around 40 months. And most of the patients are resistant or become resistant to endocrine therapy. What is the target? The target is PI3 kinase. So PI3 kinase is an enzyme that activates cell cycle. And in 40% of the patient, there is an activating mutation of PI3 kinase. And the mutation is on the gene that is PIK3CA. Okay, so we are talking about 40% of patients with luminal metastatic breast cancer that present an activating mutation on a gene. What is the drug? The drug is alpelisib. It's a PI3 kinase inhibitor. And this drug has something unique, is that it specifically targets the alpha isoform, that is the form that has the mutation. Okay, so the point of this drug is that it's a real targeted therapy in the way that it targets only the form, the isoform that has the mutation. And why is it important? Because it means it spares all the isoform involved in the normal cells. What is the design? So it's a phase 3 controlled randomized trial where the patients who are included are men or postmenopausal women. So it does not mean the men are more important, no, but it's because we cannot put postmenopausal women and men. It's but men and postmenopausal women because we have the comment, you know, so why the men first? So with HR positive, HER2 negative, to be included in the trial, the patient must have received prior aromatase inhibitor. They must have an identified PIK3CA status and measurable disease. And then the study has two components. First, we make a randomization between fulvestrant and fulvestrant plus alpelisib, that is the targeted therapy, in patients with the mutation. Okay. Then we have another cohort who are the patients who do not present the mutation. Okay, because if we want to validate the targeted therapy, we also need to validate the companion diagnosis. And this is the way to validate the companion diagnosis. And the primary endpoint is the PFS in patients with the mutation. Okay, so the hypothesis of the trial is that it works in patients with mutation. So this is the result on the primary endpoint. So primary endpoint is local assessment for PFS. And in the control arm, the median PFS was 5 months. And in the experimental arm with alpelisib, the PFS was 11 months with a hazard ratio of 0.65. And the p-value was below the predefined threshold. And we did not observe any effect or any signal of efficacy in patients who do not present the mutation. Okay, so this is really important that we have a hazard ratio 0.65 in patients with mutation and nothing in patients without mutation. We observed 35% objective response rate as compared to 16%. And the safety profile, what do we observe? We have two main side effects, that is hyperglycemia and rash. Rash is 10% grade 3, and hyperglycemia is 36% grade 3-4. But you have to keep in mind, PI3 kinase is the enzyme that makes the metabolism of glucose. So for us, actually, it's a pharmacodynamic marker.